Hundreds of thousands of tourists have been left stranded after the collapse of British tour operator Thomas Cook. British authorities are now scrambling to bring tourists home in what's being called the biggest civilian airlift since the Second World War.
For those travelling with Thomas Cook, this wasn't in the brochure.
We've just flown in from Bristol. We're rather concerned, obviously, with regards to what's going to happen, whether we'll be able to fly home or not.
I really couldn't care less. If I get stuck here, I get stuck here, don't I?
At least 150,000 people have been left stranded after the tour operator collapsed, but that figure could be as high as 600,000.
So, three people, 2 weeks in Greece, late July, let's see.
Having sent Britons on holiday for 178 years.
Don't just book it, Thomas Cook it.
The firm has been on the brink of financial ruin for many months. In July, rescue crisis talks began to save the company, with hopes its largest shareholder, Chinese bank Fosun, would come to its rescue. It didn't.
This outcome will be devastating to many people and will cause a lot of anxiety, stress, and disruption.
The company confirming its assets will be liquidated, planes impounded. Now the British aviation regulator has been called in, tasked with the largest repatriation effort since the Second World War.
This is a huge operation, 150,000 people currently abroad. We've chartered over 40 aircraft.
But it could take 2 weeks to get everyone home.
I can reassure people that in the worst case scenario, the contingency planning is there to avoid people being stranded.
As for customers who've booked upcoming trips with Thomas Cook, for now they're grounded and out of pocket. Naveen Razik, SBS World News.